touring, and it was like a little break anyway, and I think just having that break, but also being together, I don't think we had actually done any sort of writing as a whole unit before, like in one place with no distractions. And like where we were in Germany, it was like in a countryside, and we arrived there in the morning. We'd slept overnight, got there in the morning, so we didn't actually see where we were going through on the way in. But when we were coming out, it was during the day in a van, and it was crazy. It was like going through all these little towns and stuff, like they don't have traffic lights or anything. They're like proper villages. We were near nothing, and it was really relaxing.
Yeah, I think it was also just a good, like, vibe, yeah, like you said, being all together, but I'm not even sure if a whole lot, at least, like, vocally, has made it to the album, but I think it weeded out a lot of the ideas that we weren't too...
on the fence about.
Yeah, we weren't too sold on, and, it was just great to actually be able to work together, and, yeah, we've never had that opportunity.
No.
So.
I think there was, like, a couple of ideas that I had before we left for that European tour, and there might have been like four ideas or something, and I think one of them got thrown away, but Render was one of them, and I think Solar was one of them, and we would just sort of mess around with it every day and just see what we liked. At that point though, we were still unsure about like the sounds and everything that we were using. I think it was about that time we were starting to mess around with some of those weirder like electronic bits and pieces and doing some vocal things and affecting vocals in weird ways, and I think that might have been the like catalyst to sort of seeing how all the other layers and things were gonna become the foundation for the rest of the album.
Yeah, I think weirding all that out really set the focus on what we wanted to do.
Yeah, it was cool. It was really cool. The themes became more personal with Mesmer.
Yeah.
I think the stuff that Josh was talking about with Node was it was exterior. It wasn't personal. And you know, some things happened to us and to our friends over the course of writing the album. And I think, for whatever reason, they all sort of just merged into this one big thing. And I said earlier today that, you know, when a lot of people probably, some people might know, but I think a lot of people wouldn't realize that when we do these pieces of work, they are like snapshots of sort of the time of our life, like at that point in our life. And, it's hard to kind of explain, like, in music, in lyrics it's easier, but, you know.
Yes, I guess, you know, there are topics that do kind of cross over, whether it be solo and that, you know, touching on, you know, mankind kind of draining the earth of its resources and then just moving on to the next thing, I guess. But, yeah, as Charlie said, there's a lot more personal stuff on this than there has been before, and... we've always kind of have, I guess, that more worldly view of everything.
Sure.
But it's something very important to me as well, to be able to express yourself through the stuff you're going through at the time.
And unlike Node, you know, you just joined and there wasn't, I mean, you could have, we wouldn't have stopped you, but you probably didn't feel as comfortable sort of writing about those personal topics.
Absolutely.
And even with Josh, like he had been in the band since its inception, but he had only just started writing lyrics too, so he was sort of finding his feet.
Yeah.
So now that we're all comfortable with each other, with our role in the band, you know, these things are gonna just come out pretty naturally, I think.
Yeah, I think we're all a lot more confident to just do whatever we want to do. Like, I think with Node, there was a little bit of expectation, I guess. Especially for me, I was pretty intimidating. I didn't want to kind of impose too much too early. But yeah, now that we're all kind of comfortable, it's very, very important for me to do that, I guess.
Yeah. I'm imagined it would only be a good thing, like bringing an another person into the mix. I don't think we thought it was a bad thing, otherwise we probably wouldn't have done it. And like, sure, it's risky and it's all these, you know, it's nerve-wracking, you don't know how it's going to be. There's all those things, but you know, when you're challenged to do different things and work with different people, you're going to get different results. It goes without saying. And we're not, you know, we're not afraid to try different things. And the producer's one of them, the musical direction's one of them, the lyrical content's another. And I don't know if that answers the question.
Yeah, well, we've had heard from, I guess, a few people here and there, just that David was not hard to work with, but really, really pushed you. And I think that was something that was pretty exciting as well. I think something we really needed. I think with Noe, we took a bit more of a comfortable approach just with this, with the transition period. And I think, yeah, working with Bennett really kind of made us a bit uncomfortable, but really forced
supportive
us.
As well at the same time.
Yeah, made us really, really want to work hard, and yeah, it was really, really great.
Yeah, I don't think we really knew what we were in for until that first day when he took us out on the boat and sort of just, he said like, I want to figure out you guys and what all of your roles are and like the chemistry within the band so that I know how to work you guys in the studio, which is something that we've never done before, which was really cool.
He definitely like just turned it all upside down.
Yeah.
Because it was great, because in the end, he kind of broke us all down, but in the end, it made us all a lot more comfortable to, I guess, express our different ideas, and like I'm sure prior to that as well, even if it was just a little musical idea that I might think might work with the vocal, I might have been a bit, maybe I'll leave it.
Yeah.
Don't want to intrude on what John is doing, but yeah, it really gave us all the confidence to just chuck whatever we wanted in, and if everyone liked it, we'd go with it. If not, oh well, but yeah, it's still worth throwing it out there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think it wasn't hard, I guess, to bring those more personal ideas in. I think it was more so the thought process around it was a bit difficult, because it's really bringing up a bit.
The emotional.
Yeah, it's like some sour memories, whether it be Fade or being about my father passing on, our machine being about a relationship falling apart, and that, those feelings. It's something I've always, something that's been really close to my heart is writing personally, and I guess kind of letting it all out to the table. It was definitely difficult, you know, reflecting on some of those things. Say my father, Bennett and I talked for two or three days, just discussing that whole situation, everything around it. He really got to the core of it, and it was so difficult, but in the end it really brought the emotion out that was necessary, and it really, I guess, pushed me in my performance for it as well. It was, it wasn't so hard to get it out, it's hard thinking about it again, but
reliving it.
Yeah, but it's how I've always, like, written music is very personal.
But all of those topics are things that we're always interested in and always sort of have been.
Absolutely.
And I guess whether it was Adrian writing lyrics or whether it's Josh and Marcus writing lyrics, we've all sort of grown up from late teens, and we're all interested in the same thing, so, you know, to shift from one to the other wasn't difficult, I don't think. They're all Northlane topics, and we'll probably always talk about those sorts of things, because they interest us.
I don't think there is a central message. I think it's, you know, it's all stuff we have touched on before. The tagline to that is "You can be the change," and all the songs kind of reflected that in some way. Whereas this, I feel like, Yeah, it touches on a lot of that kind of stuff, but with the addition of the more personal stuff, I think that kind of brings everything together, if that makes any sense. Yeah, in a weird way, it's really, I guess, revealing all sides of Northlane that may not have been shown before. Even with Joshy writing a bit more personally as well with Viridian, it's something that was all a bit different this time around, but I think it's definitely a...
What's the overall message, if there was to be one? I don't think there is one so much as there was maybe on Node, but Mesmer's more just like a... I think it's like a statement that sort of summarizes our comfortability with ourselves and with the music that we want to write. And I think that people will, if people listen to it, they should be able to, I don't know, they should be able to get something out of it, whatever it might be. And I think that's sort of left to interpretation. But I don't know if there's like an, I don't know if there's a message in it, but you might find your own sort of message within it.